never saw it on a show, but I heard it in the alley on the weird radio. If you want a drink of water, you got to get it from a well. If you want to get to heaven, you got to raise a little hell. I never felt it in my feet, I never felt it in my soul.
We have the Landon Sorenson family who's joined us today. Jarrett's first year hunting elk, and he sure is having a good time. The twins there seem to be starving to death as they're scavenging any food they can.
Did you show Dad the coyote video?
Have not, but this will be on this episode of Sorenson Outdoors. That one buck over there.
What it is in there that he likes.
I know.
I'm gonna go to that open spot.
There's about a half a dozen coyotes. They're right down on that big flat where Jaden shot a spike a couple years ago.
You
go ahead, one, that's one, two, three. One, two, three.
Huh?
Up to the big flat. Something hit.
I killed that son of a bitch. That's 630 yards.
Right there. Oh my gosh, she scared me.
I killed that son of a bitch.
Where are they at, Kim?
He ran across the top of that.
Go straight, straight above that cedar tree, almost to the edge of the flat. You can see him flopping there.
Oh, that was fun though. Let's go get it.
What did you guys think of all that?
I can't believe I hit that son of a
bitch. Jake's the one that spotted them.
They're just sitting right in the middle of that flat. I'm sitting there. Whoa. Because you could just see him just running out of the trees.
How many was there, do you think?
A lot.
I bet there's half a dozen. That was some action. When you can't find elk to kill,
you gotta have some fun.
That's right.
270 bullets on. One coyote.
How many?
Two.
From you?
Yeah.
Hey, quiet over there, we're filming. Hi. Welcome to another episode of Sorenson Outdoors. We're going to take a, hope you've enjoyed the hunt so far. We're going to take a few minutes here. We're taking a little break. We'll put in a lot of miles on the horses today. We thought we'd do a little equipment check and tell you what we bring with us when we come on the elk hunt. First of all, you're gonna want a good pair of binoculars so you can see far away for those long shots and to identify the game you're after. Sometimes you might think it's a deer, but it could be an elk. So make sure you've got a good pair of binoculars. I also like a nice pair of bino systems. Some people go with the more expensive stuff, but I go with the cheap stuff. Because that way I can buy more equipment you know, it's, you know, more cheap stuff. Hang on, let's just, you have plenty of toilet paper. Enough for yourself because, well, you might need it. And bring some for a friend. Good radio, that's the key. Like to have some game bags in case you kill something. This is the goodie bucket.
Good night, how much stuff do you bring?
I usually bring a bag of sunflower seeds, a bag of jerky. Make sure you get this for family size.
Is there enough for a friend?
Jumbo bag, Kit Kat.
Enough for a friend, got one.
You don't want some shooting sticks?
I feel like you're ignoring my question.
Headlamp, because that's, you never know if you're going to get caught in
the dark. Yeah, I ignored.
This had my brain in earlier, I've already ate that. I got a Wyoming saw. My sharpener. I got some fire starters here, if you need those. Don't forget your rifle. If you get this, you might as well just give up. Unless.
Do you think?
You got a Wyoming knife. If you get your rifle, you might get stabbed.
Do you think, Jane, that I can have a Kit Kat? Thank you.
Don't be afraid to share your Kit Kats also.
And a horse. See the horse you got back there?
All the equipment I have aside from my packs that I got, the coat, the jacket, your orange.
What do you think about all this, Dad?
Oh, a bunch of shit. Well, I'd like to thank you for this time. And send you back to the great outdoors and all of nature.
Shoot again, Jarrett.
He's standing still. Shoot again.
Shoot again, Jarrett.
That dropped
him, bud.
He's dead. He's going to die now. Hey, that's the way to shoot.
Landon, you there? That last time he didn't?
No, I don't. Not that time. Hit him.
That hit.
Get ready. Yeah, he's rolling. Oh, he's rolling clear down.
Stay there.
You see him?
I think he's right behind that tree.
Atta boy, Jeff.
Better than cow. The cows are damn good eating.
Yeah, but that's a lot of
Dad, them. How do you?
That's a lot
don't
of
lose them.
Dad, how do we go about getting to him?
Well, we gotta ride clear back around. Trick. We got to go up on the trail and get above the slide and come down the whole son of a bitch. Unless we want to do it in the morning.
Yeah, that's what I think we can do. I'll bet my dad will come and get him.
You bet your dad will come and get him. Getting ready to go pack out Jarrett's elk that he shot last night. Jake's here with us today. Once again,
Don't waltz on me.
This little sucker will hold still. Whoa. She's kind of being skittish this morning and nervous. I think she's gonna get left behind. Whoa. Woohoo!
Looks like you bring her up there.
He hit her about 200 yards up that hill last night. And we thought she'd stay put. But she rolled all the way down this thing, right down into the creek. What do you think, Jared?
Drag her up out of the creek.
Huh?
We'll drag her up out of the water.
River run blood red. Talk about the worst spot on the mountain to kill an elk, Jarrett. Now, Jake, smile. Look at me and smile. Landon brought the old whiskey horse clear down in here. Pretty good old horse. Evidence of sex. Tuck it in the bag. In the little pannier. Get out of this hole.